I don't know what the situation was today.
She might have been meeting, like I said, I don't know.
And, but I think those employees, remember, we have four new employees in there that are still learning, so they're probably being trained. But again, there's a plan in place. I've made that clear since the day I walked in here. I've said it multiple times in meetings. And I think we're going down a very slippery slope, just pulling the plug on something like the split. Councilwoman Whit.
Yeah, I would add, making a judgment based on one day, I think is dangerous of watching. And I'm actually contrary to administration, I'm a fan of the call center. I think if it's staffed properly, I don't see where moving people, and again, if that's the choice of administration, I think that's their role. But moving people into the other departments, if you have multiple people calling at one time, you're gonna have the same issue. You're gonna have wait times. We have nine customer service agents that are serving 60,000 residents. There are going to be times that the wait time is long. I mean, that's anywhere you call. I don't like it. I think all of us would agree that we're all busy and we want to effectively communicate with the city. Again, I'll go back to the mayor's office of, we just cut a position that could provide customer service. I don't understand, and I think Chief of Staff has already pointed out that there's other departments, like this motion itself is not giving support to other departments. So when the vote is cast, keep that in mind.
Councilman Johnson, and then Councilman Brown.
I don't want to minimize Ms. Brandana's experience today, but that window over there does building, does planning, does general complaints. So if I go into the building department in Livonia, and I have to wait for the plumbing inspector to approve it, or for the vet, it's going to take more time. Each individual thing is different than the other. So I don't want to minimize hers. You know, nobody likes to wait. The call center, we're going to have that situation anywhere. And, you know, the mayor said he's going to get rid of it eventually. Not this budget, but we're going to do it. And like Ms. Councilwoman Whitten said, if we're going to move four people into the DPW to answer calls there, and you get 20 people calling the DPW, you still got the same situation. And basically, all these departments pay for these people already. So you've got the call center, they're just separated. They're in different parts of the city. It's still a call center.
Mr. Chair.
I'm sorry, Councilman Ramek has to be recognized as Councilwoman Rose, and then we'll come back to you.
Again, we talked about it, and I'll bring it back up. Remember, no matter what happens with this vote, anytime this council wants to change this budget and make an amendment, we can. So if you plan on doing something, dig deep, and if you find something that this council needs to fix, can't get the administration to fix it, then we fix it because we have every right to
plan is already in place. I'd also like to point out too, I think dismantling the call center, if you want to say, there's also seniority and, I mean, all of those things need to be worked out, I think, with, I like to bumpy, but choosing their position, it's complicated. I don't think it's something that, I know Mayor Woolley has said he was going to do it, and I don't think it's feasible to do it in 6 months either. I think there's a lot to it, and while maintaining customer service for our residents. Again, I'm a fan of it, and I think if it's staffed properly, but if the decision is made to put these into departments, it takes time and a plan, not just removing it from the budget and expecting it to be done. That's a detriment to our residents, doing it this way, in my opinion.
Councilman Johnson.
Well, just a quick point to Councilwoman's comment. There is a collective bargaining agreement. They could be moved out of there, then they have bumping rights, they can bump somebody else. One of those individuals could go into the DPW as an operator. Now, that operator that has less time will have to come here as a call person in one of the departments. So, I mean, this could ricochet around the city for a long time. To me, it should be looked at closely and done properly, not mix-matched.
Chairman?
Councilman Brandon.
Okay, so a couple of comments I had. So, of course, I don't make any decisions on one visit. I spoke to that, I had heard from residents. Residents had come up to us in our meeting, and like I said, I didn't even get to go in there. I didn't look at it really hard. I just said what I observed today. When Customer Assistance Center first came up, I was a fan of it. I thought it was very good because I remember that it was hard to get through to some of the departments. But I think that as the Mr. Bezerra had said, there's other departments in there too. So like if you're waiting in line behind someone who has a big stack of plans and they have to get permits, and they have to do all this kind of stuff, and then the person behind them has to do something, one thing. I don't know that a small item, let's say. I don't think that and then a couple other people are on the phones taking ordinance calls or whatever. I don't think that it's serving the citizens in the best way. I used to think it's a different way, but just from the complaints that I've heard and of course not one visit would make me decide anything, and this wasn't my suggestion, but I do agree with it. I do think that, and I think, you know, it's been 6 months, and while that may not seem like a very long time, we're going to be out of here in a minute. We're going to blink our eyes and it's going to be over, and so I think that it's not working. That's my opinion in the short term from the information that I have gotten and the calls that I've made.
To the chair.
Councilwoman.
Two items. One, has anyone received or is there reports available on the average wait time? I mean, if we're going to make a decision on the call center, I think that's what I would ask for. Before assuming, people complain all the time. I mean, we know that. Welcome to Facebook world where people don't ask questions, they assume, and they put it out there, and they complain. And my second question is the court counsel, do we have the authority to eliminate a department?
Mm-hmm. Plato?